Hello again to another day in Minecraft. With the advent of flying and me flying quite a bit more than in the past, the consumption of rockets has gone up and we probably should do something to keep the supply line rolling in. So we do have a sugarcane factory there, not there, but in that direction, and that should keep us supplied with paper. But what we actually need is a creeper farm for the gunpowder, and I will do this as a Nembom design with combination of basically choosing the location over an ocean or at least over water, like seen in Mambo's recent creeper farm. So let's try to get this started. This looks quite deep. There is also a ravine and a drowned. So maybe we could do it over here. Because we will dig down to bedrock, so we can have the lowest spawn level with increased spawn rates to have it down there, and that should keep us covered with gunpowder for quite some time. But first we have to get up a para. First we have to try not drowning. So let's get up. Then we have to see how we can make the perimeter, which is 9 on the diagonal, and it's basically diamond shaped and not cube shaped like the farm I did in Minecraft 1.12 version. So let's select. That will do. And from here on, I will create basically the outline for which we then can drop sand on the inside to create the wall and then section it off so we can dry it off with sponges. So lots of work for me to do. See you. So this is the last pillar for the outer section. I sectioned it off into four quarters. We will see if this is enough to sponge the water up. But first let's close this last gap in. Yep. Done. Let's get rid of the sand and get out the sponges. Let's try here in the middle. Well, it works somewhat. So, I sponged out all four quarters, and this is why we needed the iron farm. So we have haste 2, so let's clear this middle section out here. And then clear out the rest. So let's do this like this. If you have this big sand piles, it's really good. So, I made it all the way to the bottom. In the middle there we have let out 5x5 hoppers that go into that direction. So far just to the wall. And now let's sail down to have a closer look. There's a zombie somewhere. We need to place hopper minecarts on top of these hoppers so that then we can push in the magma blocks on which the creepers will eventually die. So the interesting thing is if we have blocks like this, so with different orientation of the rail, and we break the block below them, let's do this for those two. So this minecart did not change orientation, but this one turned by 90 degrees. So, and this is important because this is the longer side and this is the smaller side. If you, well, if you look at it from the side, you can see this way the minecart does not overlap the block below, but in here it does. So, and we want to place 5 minecarts besides each other and then 5 in a row. So we need to make sure that the small side is along this axis. So to do that, we want basically the minecart to lie this way, and that way we have to place the rails in this direction. So let's see that actually how this works. So we place first the 3 minecarts at the bottom. Let's quickly reassemble those. Let's grab them real quick. down. And then we need two more minecarts. The gaps in between. And we do this by dropping them in from the top here. So let's do that. And now we have one line of minecarts and we can do the next row. So I will do that quickly and then we will push in the magma blocks. So with the second row in place, we can see all are nicely aligned with this block. They are not overlapping, so we should not have any problems with getting all five rows in. If you do it the other way around, then the orientation of the minecarts will be the same, but as you can see on here, the maybe with hitboxes we can see it a bit more clearly, the hitboxes overlap in this direction, so that will be a problem latest with the third row that you want to drop in. Okay, we have the layer of magma blocks above the minecarts on top of a filler block of dirt. Then the pistons all pointing down, and if we activate this redstone with a redstone block, for example, then all pistons should activate, pushing the magma blocks into the minecarts, and we are done with that part. Yes! It worked. Like a jump, so now we have to clean up. So nice and easy, all flat, and if we drop something anywhere on here, it gets sucked up and ends up here at this end. Yes, it does. So now I can think of putting the layers, the spawn layers in place above here, and then in the end we will have water flushing everything to the middle, and from the spawn layers they will be pushed from the middle to the outside, so they drop down on the outside, and then down here they will be pushed down on the inside and take damage on here if they don't crouch, which they don't do, and we get gunpowder. So let's get on with the next step. So I've created the first platform from the center. It's blocks out, diamond shape, so when this dispenser spits out the water, it flows to the edge. Later on we'll have to do a bit more work to make sure that the creepers can spy on there, but let's first get the dispensers. So one dispenser blocks up, and the next dispenser blocks up, next dispenser. So we are back at the bottom. I put in all the layers, and on each layer we have currently a coat in this water. I will still need to add the trapdoors above here, and then make sure no spiders can spawn. Then below here I have created another exit, and below here we have the chest that collects all the goodies. But now I'm actually in the process of putting in all the water. So here on top we have 24 repeaters on max delay, preceded by a comparator on subtract with a lever behind to switch it on and off. And this corner there is currently a piece of redstone missing, so that we can keep the layers flooded with water, so working becomes easier. So now let's go and place some trapdoors. So now we have all the trapdoors in place. You can see it also, it's very dark. And to make sure that no spiders can spawn, we have to place blocks at certain locations. So from the center, it's two out and one back in every direction. And it's hard walking in water. Two out and back. And basically because spiders need an area of 3x3, if we have something, an obstacle in the way every two blocks apart, that should be good. So here and here and here and not here. Here. One block to the left. Yeah. And here. And here. And here. And we should be good for this layer. So basically I need to do that for every layer all the way down. And then we can give this a test. 96 blocks above the ground floor. And if we say ground floor is level 5, that would mean we have to go up to block 131. So I will create a EFK spot up there, and then we can give this bad boy a test run. So see you in the AFK spot. So let's get this sucker a test try. Started the timer, seems to work, and then let's launch there to our new glass cage. If I can hit it. Make this landing on top of something in a precise location quite demanding. Yep, we did it. So let's close this up and let's give us half an hour, and then we will see how much gunpowder we collected down there, and hopefully nothing else but gunpowder, but we will see. So now, 30 minutes later, moment of truth, and I should have put glass on top here. So let's go down and see how many gunpowder we have. Almost 2 stacks, but apparently it's not creeper only. We have about half the amount of spiders. And some zombies and skeletons. They should not be able to spawn in there. That's a bit worrying. And I need to look into that. But that's for another time. So thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye!